Okay, so we're going to continue with the etymology of Ethiopia. It's very important for us to trace this, right here. Now, etymology, the etymological brackets, we discussed that previously, but let's go to Ethiopia. What we're using and utilizing, once again, is the Webster's New World College Dictionary. The Webster's New World College Dictionary, for the fact that it has what's known as the etymological brackets, such as right here, the etymological brackets, and in the brackets many times, like an etymon right here, it breaks down for us exactly the literal sense of the word. It gives us etymos right here. Etymos verifies that that's true, tells us what the parts of the words actually mean. So it's not just giving us a connotative definition, but it's giving us a true word meaning. So now as we get over here to Ethiopia, it's important. Now, here is Ethiop, as we touched on before, they have archaic here. Then next to it, they have Ethiopian, right? Then we go to Ethiopia right here. They say the ancient kingdom, possibly, they put this supposition there, you understand, to cast dispersion or doubt on what we know as the truth, but they're possibly dating to the 10th century B.C., possibly dating to the 10th century B.C. Well, we know that this is the approximate time that it occurred, the Solomon and the Queen of Sheba, you understand, encounter. Now, they say that Ethiopia is an ancient kingdom in northeast Africa, a Davidic kingdom, a Judaic kingdom, on the Red Sea, corresponding to modern Sudan and northern Ethiopia, the country. And now we also have South Sudan now, which is a Christian nation. Now it breaks down the square miles. Now they say a country in East Africa, secondary on the Red Sea, established, they say, in 1855. But how could it be established in 1855 and yet be an ancient kingdom? You see what they try to do? They try not to give a late date. And this is where the controversy comes in. They say it's 4,771,800 square miles, and they break it down, the capital, Addis Ababa. But now let's go to the second one, which corresponds to this one right here, the archaic Ethiopian, see what they say right here. On the Ethiopian, they say adjective of Ethiopia is people or culture, right? Archaic, they say the black sense. It means black in the old sense. In the older dictionaries, you would actually have Negro. You actually have Negro there. In the older dictionaries, they actually have Negro instead of just regular so-called black. But it said designating or of biogeographic, I want you to get this, realm. It says designating, it either designates or is of the biogeographic realm that includes Madagascar and all of Africa except some parts of North Africa in the Palearctic realm. So what they're telling us right here, that Ethiopian properly means black, or what Negro, black, Negro is the Spanish and Portuguese way of saying black, but then in the English sense, black. So both of them refer to Ethiopian. Then they're telling us next that it designates or is of the biogeographic realm that includes Madagascar, which is like an island-type nation, and all of Africa. So right here in the Webster's New World, notice a New World College Dictionary is telling us that the true name of Africa is actually Ethiopia. You understand? And the true designation of black people is actually Ethiopian, because Ethiopia is an ancient empire. Not just a kingdom, but it's an empire. That means you have other kingdoms within that empire. This is where they try to confuse people, you understand? And this is where many become confused about these matters. Now they say that as a noun, as an adjective, we were discussing before, but now as a noun, it's a native or inhabitant, it says, of Ethiopia. Archaic sense, you notice this right here? In the archaic sense, it's a black person. In the archaic sense, it's a black person. This is very important. Now, what we thought is even more important is Ethiopic, is as Ethiopic is used. Let's just move a couple of things around here, and let's go back to the Queen of Sheba, only son Menelik, You remember, you recall this? Queen of Sheba and only son Menelik. We went through this already. It says it was translated from what? What's that right there? It was translated from the Ethiopic, right, by Sir E.A. Wallace Budge. Ethiopic. You see Ethiopic right there? I want you to now, we're going to go and define, according to the dictionary, Ethiopic. All right? Now, according to the definition here, it says Ethiopic adjective. Now, here's the open etymological brackets. It says Ethiopicus, derived from the Greek Ethiopikos, and then it says derived from Ethiops, Ethiopian. They said literally, with burnt face, they say is derived from Athian, which means to burn. And then they say sea ether. You see that right there? It says sea ether. You understand? See the ether. Wow. Plus ops or ops, which means face or eye. Face or eye. Then it's a double bracket, closed etymological bracket. Now it says Ethiopian. Firstly, Ethiopic refers to Ethiopian. Therefore, that refers to black or Negro people. Therefore, that refers to the all of Africa. You see that? All of Africa. All of Africa. So, Ethiopian, Ethiopic. Then it says, designating or of the Semitic, you see that? Of the Semitic languages. Of the Semitic languages of the Ethiopians, the Shem, the name languages, the Shem, or the Yahweh languages, the Shem, languages of Ethiopia, of the Ethiopians. It says the classic what? Semitic language of Ethiopia, still used as a liturgical or kadase language of the Christian church of Ethiopia, one of the oldest in the world, Acts of the Apostles, chapter 8, the Ethiopian eunuch. You understand? Secondly, it says a group of Semitic or Shemitic languages, it says, spoken in Ethiopia, including classical Ethiopic. So this is a very important definition. It is telling us right here, it is basically proving and verifying exactly what the Kibra Negest, or the translation called the Queen of Sheba and her only son Menelik, has in it. And we'll see if we can bring this to you. It's in one of the earlier chapters which discuss how the Ethiopians, you understand, the Ethiopians are of the people of Shem, are Shemites. Now, this will, of course, confuse certain Bibleators, you understand, certain Bibleators, because these Bibleators, you understand, do not have all of the facts. And when they get all of the facts, then they will recognize the half of the story that they haven't been told. But here in the Kibra Negest, I think it's going to discuss for us how the Ethiopians, maybe we'll look under the index and we'll bring it to you. But let's see if we can get Shem. Well, you see right here, where is it? Shem. You see right there, these are the different areas for Shem. That's on page 6, 8, 9. So we'll bring that to you in the next part.